Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To start this video, I couldn't give information about it last video, but on Saturday, SpaceX launched another batch of Starlink satellites with the Starlink 4-4 mission.
Zero, ignition, liftoff of the Falcon 9, go Starlink.
The booster which launched to this mission, B-1051, then landed successfully for a staggering 11th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Less than 24 hours later, and SpaceX launched another satellite earlier this morning with the launch of TurkSat 5B.
Zero, ignition, and liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1052, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas. To add to these two launches, SpaceX is planning to launch yet another Falcon 9 mission in a couple of days. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, the CRS-24 mission is expected to lift off on Tuesday 21st at 10:06 a.m. UTC or 5:06 a.m. Eastern Time. There was an exciting article posted by NASA in relation to Starship launches from Cape Canaveral. It says, in response to an inquiry from SpaceX, NASA is preparing to conduct environmental assessments to develop a proposed new launch site, Launch Complex 49, at the agency's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. This new antenna was spotted being installed onto Starhopper. Another prefabricated section of the wide bay was installed onto the structure. As well as that, the third prefabricated section for the second level was installed. Somebody posted a video of a Raptor engine test at SpaceX's McGregor facility. Musk responded with, all Raptor 2 tests going forward. There was a cool Starship picture posted with a caption of, Starship is one of the biggest breakthroughs since the early days of human existence. Musk responded and said, still much to be done, but it has that potential. Elon Musk posted this cool video of Super Heavy gimballing its center engines during some testing. He then posted a response tweet saying, each Raptor 1 engine above produces 185 metric tons of force. Raptor 2 just started production and will do 230 plus tons or over 500,000 pounds of force. Musk was asked, what is the gimbal range on these? He responded and said, 15 degrees. Chris Burgin posted the video with the caption, some sweet TVC thrust vector control gimbal action from the Center 9 Raptor gang on the booster. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how the booster steers. Musk responded and said, yep, next booster will have 33 Raptor 2 engines with 13 steering. Ship is being upgraded to 9 engines, 3 sea level gimballing, 6 vacuum fixed with increased propellant load. He was then asked, any other changes to ship to accommodate this? Musk responded with, the ship is just begging for 3 more vacuum engines to be added. Tanks will stretch for more propellant load. There was another tweet posted saying, Starship full thrust. What's timeline like for first Starship launch from Cape? Musk responded and said, this is not even its final form, although pretty close. Cape is hopefully this summer. Here's a view of some work they've recently been doing on the flap of Starship SN15. Work has continued on Starship 20 to prepare it for its next static fire. These interesting new orange pieces were spotted installed onto Ship 20. The Ship 21 nosecone barrel section was recently moved inside the high bay. The body section of Starship 21 has now also been rolled out of the mid bay. In the mid bay in the background, you can see the progress on Starship 22. These ropes from the hat we saw on B2.1 were seen unfurled recently. During the week, the Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype performed some cryogenic proof testing. Chris Burgin posted a tweet to Musk asking very interesting news about the upgrade to ship's capability. Which booster and ship combination are you aiming to fly the first orbital test with? Still booster 4 and ship 20, or use them only for ground testing? Elon Musk responded with, still aiming for booster 4 and ship 20 for first orbital test flight. This is pure coincidence. Here's a look at the road and beach closures again on the Cameron County website, where there are a whole load of closures posted. Starting with this coming week, there are closures for all weekdays from Monday 20th until Thursday 23rd, but nothing for Friday 24th. Then, next week, there are further closures with Monday 27th until Thursday 30th. The new Booster 6 test tank was seen moved to the propellant production site. As always, I have to say thank you to both Mary or Boca Chica Gala Nikansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.